question is, we had just seen Republican senators from New York who were voted in because they were supposed to be conservative and came in and voted for gay marriage in New York. How do you feel about that?
I question whether they're true social conservative Republicans. I believe that marriage is between a man and a woman. I believe that the God that I worship made it that way, and we shouldn't be tampering with that.
Amen.
Many people say, feel that the Federal Reserve System is an unconstitutional system. It acts in secret, and we pay interest to banks that we really shouldn't have to, and that much of our debt, our debt problem in this country is due to the Federal Reserve System. Can you tell me your position on the Federal Reserve?
You know, any time there's a system, quasi-government system, that doesn't seem to have a mechanism for accountability, I'm suspect. I think individuals need to be accountable. I think governments need to be accountable. I think anybody in public office needs to be held accountable. I believe, whether you call it an audit or an open discussion about what goes on, I do understand that the Federal Reserve and some of the things that they do can influence monetary activities in our country. Whether it's your investments, or my investments, or the rest of the way that the money system works. But I also believe that there should be transparency from the Federal Reserve, and I believe many of the ways we have done business in our government need to be looked at more closely, and I believe we need some folks there that have actually lived on Main Street. When you look at how our government is made up, whether it's from our Secretary of Treasury, or from our President, or from many of the people in the U.S. Senate, they don't come from the same places we do. Okay? They don't go to local schools. They don't go to local state universities. They don't spend their life on Main Street. They spend their life on Pennsylvania Avenue or Wall Street. We need more people like ourselves representing us. When our country was founded, it was founded on the basis of citizens volunteering to go to Washington or go to their state capitals and serving the people and going back home. What we have now is a system of people that do nothing but run for public office. Some of them start in their 20s, and they're still running 40 and 50 years later. If you've never signed in front of a check, if you've never been faced with having to live up to the regulations and laws that we face as business people and people just trying to make a living. If you see other people not paying taxes while you're paying taxes, it's not right. Who's going to speak up for the Main Street people? Who's going to speak up for people and be able to have enough of experiences to take on some of these tasks? I think I have that experience. I think I've earned the right to represent people, and I'm asking for that support and for that vote. And if I get to the United States Senate, I will work very hard every day to live up to that promise. And I will always make a decision that I believe is right for the American people and right for the people of Florida, irrespective of what it might do to the future political career that I might have.
Could you just give us your analysis of the relationship between the world debt crisis and world central banking?
You know, whether it's the way we've been running our government here or the way we've been, other governments have been run in Europe and other places, clearly the old economies, particularly the European economies, have become soft. They've become soft because they've overpromised to their citizens. They don't have enough taxpayers. They have too many tax users. That is symptomatic of many of the problems that currently exist in countries like Greece, Italy, Spain, Portugal. We have to wake up to the fact that it is a new day. If we're going to be a debtor nation and we're going to owe $14 trillion, most of it, almost half of it, to Asian countries. We need to wake up to the fact that the expectations for our place in the world are likely to change. That's why getting a balanced budget put in place, getting us to the point where we live within our means, is so darn important. And we need to send people to Washington that know how to do that. These are not problems we can't fix. These are not problems we can't overcome. I've been in a situation before where I've had businesses that don't work. Okay? You got two choices, and you got a bad restaurant. You close it, or you fix it. I'm a fixer of problems, and when I recognize that it can't be fixed, I will close it. We need some programs that are going on in Washington shut down because they don't work, and they're not worth the money we're paying for it. We need to pay dividends to our citizens, not overtax them. If you spend more money than you have as an individual or as a business, you go out of business or you go personally bankrupt. You don't spend every dime when things or times are good. You set aside something for the future. We haven't done that.
Two more questions. We have Mike, then the mayor.
First of all, I'd like to acknowledge our appreciation to you for your willingness to serve.
Thank you, sir.
Should you be fortunate enough to win the election in 2012, he will be presiding over the implementation of national health care. What will you do? We need a watchdog in the Senate.
Well, I've been called a dog before, so I'll take that with what it was intended. We not only need people that are willing to stand up and serve, and I point out that Florida is the hospitality capital of the world. I come from the hospitality business. It's time that we send people that have been active in the service industry to Washington, because we come from a different place. We come from a different place. And I am proud to stand forward and give my time and my energy and my passion and my love for my country to serve in the United States Senate. I think I'm going to get elected, or I wouldn't do this. I'm not someone that needs to go out and spend the next 16 months trying to do something. I'm going to spend the next 16 months doing something. I'm going to be a leader, and I'm going to be a force, and I'm going to be a voice. And you know what? When you don't really care whether you spend 6 or 12 years doing something, you're unshackled. You're unshackled. And I've never been shackled in my life. I don't intend to be if I get elected to the United States Senate. I will do what I think is right for the people of the state of Florida. I am a listener. Every time I ever went into one of my restaurants, the first thing I did was go to the kitchen and talk to the dishwasher. And I want to know what the dishwasher's thinking and what that person feels. I've had my hands in hot water for 12 hours at a time. I know what it's like to work in the kitchen. And if the dishwasher breaks down, you can't serve in front of the House. I'm going to go to Washington, and I'm going to clean up the mess that the rest of these politicians have brought upon us. And I will do that. I promise you I'll do that. Last question, please.
Hi, my name is Amanda. I'm president of the Sarasota County Young Republicans. And anyone who's ever read the Young Republicans Be a Rebel flyer knows my big issue as a lifetime member of the NRA is guns. If elected, how will you help preserve our Second Amendment rights?
Well, I tell you, the NRA, which I am a member, does a fantastic job keeping us all informed on the threats to the rights to bear arms. If you go on my website, you'll see a picture of me as a hunter. I'm not a hunter, okay? That wasn't a canned picture, though. I did go hunting when that picture was taken. The Constitution, whether it's the Second Amendment, or the First Amendment, or any amendment, as long as it's part of the Constitution, needs to be defended. There are certain things that are in place, and the rule of law, and the right to bear arms is something that every American believes in or should believe in. And I will always be a supporter of the Second Amendment. I want to thank you all very much.
Okay. Thank you, Sarasota. Thank you.